So hello students, today we see some more interesting points about the long form of periodic table. Okay, already we know the long form of periodic table having how many periods? 7 periods and 18 groups. The left side metals are present, so right side mainly non-metals. At the end of the table at the right side, noble gas are present and the middle elements are treated as transition elements. It's the total main body, so that the bottom of the total body of the table, two rows are present, the lanthanides and actinides. Okay, so now we see about this the table. Okay, so first we see the 1A group elements. What are 1A group elements? Hydrogen, so lithium, sodium, so potassium, rubidium, cesium and francium. Okay, like so what is the second A group element? Second A group element, first we see the alkaline earth metals, next non-metals 13 14, so total manaki 18 vertical columns it is not possible kada. So first manaki metals next non-metal draw chesin tarvata we discuss about the middle element, that is about transition elements. Okay, so this is 1A group element. Next beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium and radium. So this is the 1A group elements and 2A group elements. Okay, so in the periodic table at the left side they are present. This is called 1A group elements. This is 2A group elements. Okay, so what are 1A group elements? If you observe the 1A group elements, for example hydrogen, what is the configuration? 1s1. What is the lithium? So what is the lithium atomic number? 3. Atomic numbers 3. So what is its configuration? 1s2, 2s1. What is the sodium atomic number? 11. So what is the electronic configuration? We know already, we discussed in the atomic structure lesson. That is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. What is the potassium? This is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, that is 4s1. So remaining also it become very lengthy. So means if you observe the their electronic configurations, the outermost having 1s1. This is the outermost shell. What is the outermost shell here? Second shell is the outermost shell, so that is having 2s1. In sodium, what is the outermost shell? 3. That is only 3s1. In the potassium, what is the outermost shell? Fourth shell is the outermost shell. So it is having 4s1. Means inside electrons are different because atomic number different only. కాబట్టి నంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ డిఫరెన్స్ ఉంటాయి కాబట్టి ఇన్నర్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ నంబర్ డిఫరెన్స్ ఉంది. బట్ జనరల్ ఫర్ కెమికల్ ప్రాపర్టీస్ ఆల్ వి నో ద కెమికల్ ప్రాపర్టీస్ ఆర్ మెయిన్లీ డిపెండ్స్ ఆన్ ఎలక్ట్రానిక్ కాన్ఫిగరేషన్. ఓకే, సో ఎలక్ట్రానిక్ కాన్ఫిగరేషన్, అవుటర్ ఎలక్ట్రానిక్ కాన్ఫిగరేషన్. సో ఇన్సైడ్ ఎలక్ట్రానిక్ కాన్ఫిగరేషన్తో దెర్ ఇస్ నో బాదర్ అబౌట్ ఇట్ బికాస్ దే డో నాట్ ఇన్వాల్వ్ ఇన్ ద రియాక్షన్స్. Only outer most electrons are only involved in the chemical reactions. So ee group elements annitlo unnai, all are having same type of configuration. So atle mana pod rubidium iskunte we will get 5s1, 6s1, 7s1 of the next last lo. So these are the outer most configuration. So commonly we can write for 1A group element general electronic configuration is ns1. So n equal to 1 2 3 4 5 6, whatever it is, 7 were branch. Okay, and if you lose this for lithium, if it lose this electron it becomes helium configuration. For sodium, if it lose one electron it becomes neon configuration. Potassium, if it loses one electron it becomes argon configuration. Okay, so like this all 1A group elements are placed perfectly in the modern periodic table. And in any, if you observe any group in the long form of periodic table, all are showing similar chemical properties. So how we say directly they are showing similar chemical properties with some changes. And one most reactive avachu, one less reactive avachu, but the property will be nearly equal because they are all having same outermost electronic configuration. Okay, so they are known as alkali metals. Here one more important: hydrogen is not a metal. Hydrogen is a non-metal. So except hydrogen, all these are perfect metals. Means if you write these points for 1A group elements, you will write some points. Okay, 1A group nothing but it is also called first group. First group are known as alkali metals. Alkali metals. So what is the general valency configuration? General outer electronic configuration. What is that? NS1. Okay. Next, all are except hydrogen. Actually, the position of hydrogen is non-metal. Non-metal. Remaining all are good metals. Good, they are all soft metals. Okay, so all are having same configuration. Means the position of alkali metals in the periodic table is perfectly correct. Okay, see the atomic numbers. So potassium is 19, so this is 37, this is 55. So what about the francium? It's at 32, 87. Here it is 88. Simple, 56, 38, 20, 12. Okay. So this is about alkali metals. Now we see some points about the second A group elements. So second A group elements be nothing but a normal number, is the second vertical column. So they known as alkaline. They known as alkaline earth metals. Okay. So next, what is the general electronic configuration? General outer electronic configuration. Well, NS2. So if you observe some example, for example beryllium, what is the configuration? 1s2, 2s2. It's atomic number 4. Okay, 1s2, 2s2. So we have 1A group elements for the configuration, right? Okay. So magnesium, so 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2. For calcium, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s1. So 20 raha hai, okay? So here, if you observe, say for strontium, you will get 5s2, 6s2, next 7s2. So this is a valency outermost shell, second is having 2s2, having s2. Next, if you lose this beryllium lose this electron, so beryllium will get helium configuration. If it loses this lost electron, magnesium loses, it becomes neon configuration. So if calcium loses its two electrons, valency two electron, it becomes argon configuration. Okay, that is 18. Okay, like this, so all are having similar property, losing two electrons in their valency, and they get their nearest to noble gas configuration. Nearest to noble gas, and beryllium near ground noble gas helium. మెగ్నీషియం కి ఇక్కడ 12, దీని నియర్ ఉండే నోబుల్ గ్యాస్ కాన్ఫిగరేషన్ ఏంటి నియాన్. సో కాబట్టి వి కెన్ సే ద సెంటెన్స్ దట్ ఆఫ్టర్ లూజింగ్ టూ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్, టూ వ్యాలెన్సీ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్, దే విల్ గెట్ దేర్ నియరెస్ట్ నోబుల్ గ్యాస్ కాన్ఫిగరేషన్. So next, all are having the other, they are also metals. So they are all metals. There is no exception. They are all metals. They are also soft, but they are compared to 1D group element, they are hard. Metals, soft metals. But harder than, but they are harder than 1A group metals. Okay. So next we see here one more important point. So the important point is in 1A group francium, in 2A group radium. These are radioactive elements. These are called radioactive elements. So what is mean by radioactivity? So radioactivity is a specific property. So any elements ki radioactivity undadu. So a specific elements ki radioactivity undadu. So why they are having radioactivity nature? Means it is depends on their nature. Okay, totally nature. So okay, for example, 1A group lo manaki francium, second group lo radium. They shows radioactivity. Radioactivity means they independently decompose. They independently disintegrates and releases alpha or beta or gamma radiations. ఆటోమేటిక్గా మనం దాన్ని ఏం చేయకుండా కూడా ఆటోమేటిక్గా దే ఆర్ అన్స్టేబుల్ అనమాట. సో విత్ ఇన్ ఫ్రాక్షన్ ఆఫ్ మినిట్స్, అంటే డిఫరెంట్ టైమ్స్లో కొన్నిటికి కొన్ని సెకండ్స్ హాఫ్ టైం, కొన్నిటికి మినిట్స్ టైం ఉంటుంది. సో ఆ కొంచెం టైంలో ఏమవుద్ది అంటే ఇండిపెండెంట్లీ మనం సపరేట్ ఏం చేయకుండా, సో ఇండిపెండెంట్లీ దే రిలీజెస్ ఆల్ఫా బీటా గామా రేడియేషన్ అండ్ చేంజ్ ఇన్ టు అదర్ న్యూక్లియస్, అంటే వేరే ఎలిమెంట్లోకి కన్వర్ట్ అయిపోతాయి. ఓకే, మీన్స్ కంటిన్యూగా ఆల్ఫా బీటా గామా రేడియేషన్స్ రిలీజ్ అవుతూనే ఉంటాయి. ఆల్ఫా ఆర్ బీటా ఆర్ గామా రేడియేషన్స్ రిలీజ్ అవుతాయి. ఓకే, దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ రేడియో యాక్టివిటీ. మీన్స్ ఇన్ 1A, దిస్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ థింగ్. సో ఇన్ 1A గ్రూప్ ఫ్రాన్షియం, ఇన్ 2A గ్రూప్ రేడియం, exhibit radioactivity. Okay, so this is about alkali metals and alkaline earth metals. They are also separately known as 1A, 2A, combinedly known as combinedly known as S block elements. Just S block elements. So what S block? So మనకు సెపరేట్ గా బ్లాక్స్ టాపిక్ ఉంది, బట్ మన టోటల్ టేబుల్ గురించి డిస్కస్ చేస్తున్నాం కాబట్టి జస్ట్ వీఆర్ సేయింగ్ ద వర్డ్ దీస్ టూ ఆర్ సపరేట్లీ నోన్ యాజ్ ఎస్ బ్లాక్ ఎలిమెంట్స్. ఓకే, సో నెక్స్ట్ we see non metal groups. Okay, for example, take 13th group, nothing but so beryllium. So actually manaki beryllium, so ee group tarvata, so actually there is a gap of 10 groups. You have to draw separately. Okay, so ikkada manaki total 10 groups untayi. So ee 10 groups gap tarvata next em ostundi manaki Beryl is boron. So this is called a third A. Third A nothing but it is a 13th group. If 10, 11, 12, 13. So this is boron. So aluminium. So gallium. Indium. Thallium. So next, there is a modern periodic some more is there. Okay, see here. Next, so now we discuss about the 13th group elements. See, 13th group elements, what is our numbers? Boron 5. So, aluminium 13. Okay, so aluminium 13 means gallium here, 18 difference will be there. Okay, that is 31. Next, 49, 18 gap for it. Next again here 32 gap. Okay, 32 gap means we will get 81. Okay, so if you see their configuration, so my third A group elements configuration, you say what about boron? So boron 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. So what about aluminium? So 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p1. So 13 level. Okay, so gap becomes very high. So, but what is the valency configuration? So, general configuration, I have important. So, what is the general configuration here? So, it is outermost shell is the second is the outermost shell. So, outermost shell, at a, so last one, okay, treat the last highest number, 2s2, 2p1. Here, 3s2, 3p1. Next, 4s2, 5s2, 6s2, 6p1. Okay, means general electronic configuration, general valency configuration, we can write. NS2 NP1. Okay, if you write about third A group elements, third A group elements nothing but they are 13th group elements. Okay, so 13th group elements general configuration, that is NS2 NP1. Thus we can write some examples: 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. S2 3p1. So if you observe these elements in the groups will observe this number, you get a 5. So 5 13, you get a gap into only 8. 5 plus 8 13. Next 13 plus 18, so you get 18 gap. Okay, 31. So next 31 keep only 49, again 18 gap. Okay, 31 18 49. So the last gap into it is 32 gap. So that is 32. Sorry, 49, 32, 81. Here also we get the same, 4 plus 8, 12, 8, 20. Okay, next, 18, 18, okay, 32 gap, okay. So next, 14th group. Fourth A, it is also called the 14th group. What is the 14th group? Boron. It's a carbon 6. Silicon. Germanium. Okay, germanium. Next, tin, SN, okay, so 50, 32, 18, 50. Next, last one, lead, 82. Okay, if you see what, can you guess what is the general electronic configuration? So, for carbon, it is 1s2, 2s2, 2p2, sorry, 2p2, carbon 6 means general configuration NS2 NP2. So if you write the silicon, silicon 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p2. So 14, okay, 10, 14. So 3s2, 3p2. So like this, we can write the general configuration of 14th group elements is NS2, NP2. Means the 40A group elements, nothing but 14th group elements. What is general configuration? NS2, NP2. So we can't say all our metals and all our non-metals metalloid, because in non-metal groups, so they also contain some non-metals or some metalloids and also metals also. For example, here tin lead is a good metals, tin lead or metals. Okay, silicon, germanium or semi-metals, metalloids. Okay, carbon is perfect non-metal. Silicon, germanium, the metalloids, tin, lead, they're metals. Okay, means all three metals are extra to simple, they are metals, total they are metals. We can't write it because it's combining of metals, non-metals and metalloids. So can you guess the 15th group, 16th group, 17th group configurations? Now we write them directly. Next, 5th A, 5th A low nitrogen 7, phosphorus 15, arsenic, antimony, next bismuth, okay, next 6th A, oxygen, what is number 8, sulfur, selenium. Next, tellurium, polonium. Actually, what is the importance of this polonium? And here, so it could be lead, so bismuth, not a radioactive elements, but it could have polonium is a radioactive element, just like radium, francium, like a polonium is also radioactive element. Actually, the polonium is name is given in the name of country name, that is Poland. So Poland country name nunchi polonium name ichchu. Actually, the scientist Curie discovered first time to this polonium. So her country is Poland. That's why she given the name it as polonium. Okay. Means it represents Poland. Next, 7th A, nothing but 17th group. You have to write these configurations. Okay, already you know the configurations. So oxygen, so fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, astatine, next last one, zero group, that but it is also called 18th group. So it actually helium, it can start out the helium 2. So zero group, or it is also called, you know that it is 18th group, they are called noble gases in the helium. Ne, okay, it is Ne, neon. Argon. So atomic number left side down low undal, okay. Next, krypton. Xenon. Radon. 86. Here radon also is a also radioactive elements. So this is the right side part of the periodic table. So extreme right side end and we know that noble gases, that is helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. Just we have to remember their atomic numbers also. 2, 8 gap ikda, okay? 10, mali 8 gap, 18. Next 18 gap, 36. Mali 18 gap, 54. Last 32 gap, that is 86. Okay, so mali last lo koche gap and those ante 32 gap osari. Okay, and then periods going to discuss this step, we know why the gap is 8, 18, so what gap and the kundi and discussion change. For example, we can have 2 gap in the places. So only 2 places, 1 tarvata 3, 2 tarvata, so ikkada 8 gap achindi, okay. Helium, neon. So there's gap is 2 gap is present. So why there is only 2 gap? So remaining any places lo manaki 8 atla gap vachindi, only 2 gap vachindi ikkada okka degara, that is hydrogen lithium, because hydrogen tarvata unda element manaku only helium, tarvata internal lithium starting ante actually this is the first row em cheppochunte manam, this is horizontal row, first period. So first period la 2 elements untayi kabatti, so second period ku vachesariki starting ante vachindi just 2 ne gap vachindi. So next nunchi manaki 8 gap vastadi. So enduku 8 gap vastante ikkada 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 elements are there. 8 elements kabatti, so 3 ki 11 ki 8th gap vachindi. So next kuda ante ikkada, so ikkada malli 10 groups ani cheppestam, 11 sodium, magnesium, aluminium. So this is called third period. Ee third period kuda enni elements unda manaki, 8 elements unda. So 8 elements unda kabatti 11 tarvata malli dan next element ki how much will be gap? 8 will be gap. And it depends on elements present in the number of period. So if first period only 2 elements negative, first second gap 2 the second period, third period gap 8, because in second period e line manam second period, second period only 8 elements, so ikkada gap ikkade undan manaki. Next 10 groups ikkada kuda gap, so ikkada second third to fourth kuda gap 8 e undi. Third period to fourth period, but there is only gap 8. So, because third period low elements are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 periods. 8 elements in the gap. I think potassium, the fourth period under the is fourth period, which is fifth period. So, try to understand carefully. So, fourth period, which is fifth period, 1937, 20, 38, 31, 49, and 18 gap. Why 18 gap? అంటే ఇక్కడ ఈ ఫోర్త్ పీరియడ్ లో ఫిఫ్త్ పీరియడ్ లో ఎన్ని ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఉన్నాయంటే 18 ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఆర్ దేర్. 18 ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఉన్నాయిట్లా 1, 2. సో ఇక్కడ 10 గ్రూప్స్ ఇక్కడ స్టార్ట్ అవుతుంది, అంటే ఈ టోటల్ మన లాంగ్ ఫామ్ ఎక్కడ స్టార్ట్ అయింది అంటే ఇక్కడ ఫోర్త్ పీరియడ్ నుంచి స్టార్ట్ అవుతుంది. సో ఫర్ ఫస్ట్ పీరియడ్ లో జస్ట్ 1 ఒకటి, ఇక్కడ ఎండింగ్ లో ఒకటి 2 ఏ ఉంటాయి. నెక్స్ట్ సెకండ్ పీరియడ్ లో ఇక్కడ 2 ఉంటాయి, మధ్యలో గ్యాప్ ఉంటుంది, నెక్స్ట్ ఇక్కడ 6 ఉంటాయి. థర్డ్ పీరియడ్ కూడా మళ్ళీ ఇక్కడ 2 ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఉంటాయి, మళ్ళీ గ్యాప్ ఉంటుంది, ఇక్కడ 6 ఉంటాయి. కానీ ఇక్కడ ఫోర్త్ నెక్స్ట్ వచ్చే పీరియడ్స్ అంటే ఫస్ట్ సెకండ్ థర్డ్ ఏంటంటే డిస్కంటిన్యూస్ పీరియడ్స్, మధ్యలో గ్యాప్ వస్తుంది. ఫోర్త్ ఫిఫ్త్ సిక్స్త్ సెవెంత్ పీరియడ్స్కి ఏంటంటే గ్యాప్ ఉండదు, జస్ట్ స్ట్రైట్ గా ఉంటుంది. ఓకే, సో ఆ గ్యాప్ మధ్యలో ఎందు ఉన్నాయంటే ఇక్కడ 10 గ్రూప్స్ పడతాయి గ్యాప్ లో, ఇవి 10, 11, 12, ఇక్కడ 6, 18. నెక్స్ట్ ఇక్కడ ఒక దగ్గర మనకి సిక్స్త్ పీరియడ్ సెవెంత్ పీరియడ్ దగ్గర లాంథనైడ్స్ ఆక్టనైడ్స్ బాటమ్ లోకి వెళ్ళిపోతాయి కాబట్టి అది 28. సో టోటల్ యాడ్ చేసి అక్కడ 32 ఎలిమెంట్స్ అయితే ఆ పీరియడ్ లో, కాబట్టి గ్యాప్ విల్ 32. ఓకే, హియర్ వన్ మోర్ ఇంపార్టెంట్, దిస్ నాన్ మెటల్ గ్రూప్స్ దట్ ఈస్ 13th, 14th, 15th, 16th, 17th గ్రూప్స్ దే ఆర్ ట్రీటెడ్ యాజ్ నాన్ మెటల్ గ్రూప్ ఈవెన్ దే కంటెయిన్ సమ్ మెటల్స్ ఆల్సో. ఇక్కడ ఆస్టర్టిన్ ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఇక్కడ ఫ్లోరిన్, క్లోరిన్, బ్రోమిన్, ఐయోడిన్ ఆర్ నోన్ యాజ్ హాలోజన్స్, లైక్ దీస్ ఆర్ కాల్డ్ నోబుల్ గ్యాసెస్, దే ఆర్ సపరేట్. అయితే ఇన్ నౌ ఇన్ నౌ ద ఎలిమెంట్స్ యాక్చువల్గా ఇప్పటిదాకా మనం డిస్కస్ చేసింది ఓన్లీ అబౌట్ ద పీరియాడిక్ టేబుల్ గివెన్ అకార్డింగ్ టు ద నీల్స్ బోర్ స్టార్టింగ్ లో, బట్ నౌ ద ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఆర్ ఆల్సో డిస్కవర్డ్ అండ్ దిస్ బాటమ్ కాలమ్ ఆల్సో. ఈవెన్ ఇప్పటిదాకా మనం డిస్కవర్ అయిన ఎలిమెంట్స్ 118 ఉన్నాయి. సో 118 అంటే దిస్ లాస్ట్ వన్, దిస్ రిమెంబర్ 118 అంటే దట్ బిలాంగ్స్ టు 18th గ్రూప్. సో ఇక్కడ మనం 32 చేస్తే 18 వస్తుంది కదా, దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ ఆర్గనైసాన్, ఓజీ అంటాం ఆర్గనైసాన్. is 118. Next, what will the 32 address there? It's got tennis sign. Tennis sign. TS. Next. Livermorium. Okay, Livermorium. LV. Livermorium. Next, 115. So, 115. Muscovium. Muscovium. Next, Flerovium. 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 Next, Nihonium. So, NH. Starting letter capital, though, second letter small letters. Starting letter capital compulsory, second letter compulsory small letter. It's called Nihonium, Flerovium, Muscovium, Livermorium, Tennyson, and Organison. So now these are also discovered. We have to remember these also. Okay. So next one more important. This 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 elements are commonly known as P-block elements. Okay. So why they are P-block, what are the other characters, and then separately the topic will discuss with them. So now we can say these are P-block elements. So actually I'm going to total the draw this, that will be better one. But my board size in the but we can't draw the total periodic table at once. Means now 1A, 2A are comes under S block. And even 1 comma 2. Next remaining 3A, 4A, sorry. 50A, 60A. 70A, 0, they comes under P block. So here important is, so what is the general electronic configurations? So general valency configuration of these elements. General outermost configurations. So what are their configurations? NS1, NS2, NS2 NP1, NS2 NP2, NS2 NP3. Just remember this is a 50A, 3 plus 2, 5. So what? Just remember NS2 is 16th group, nothing but 60A. That is NS2 NP4, 4 plus 2, 6, 6A. NS2 NP5, 7, 7, okay. This is 0 or 18th group means it's complete. NS2 NP6. Okay. So these are about the S block and P block elements. Actually, we have discussed this in terms of groups. Okay. So left side groups, right side groups. So tomorrow in the next session, we see the middle element, that is transition elements. Next, bottom rows, that is inner transition elements. Okay, but it is important you have to remember the total periodic table 100%. So helmet is the A group loan, the A period loan. You have to remember that points. Actually, A group, A period, there is a simple technique is also there. For example, if an element is given, so for example silicon, element silicon belongs to which group and it belongs to which period. So ఇట్లా మనకి జనరల్ గా దేర్ ఇస్ మెనీ క్వశ్చన్స్ ఆర్ దేర్. సో ఇటువంటి క్వశ్చన్ మనం సాల్వ్ చేయడానికి వి హావ్ టు రిమెంబర్ ఇట్స్ అటామిక్ నంబర్ అండ్ కాన్ఫిగరేషన్. వాట్ ఇస్ ద సిలికాన్ అటామిక్ నంబర్? 14. సో రైట్ ఇట్స్ కాన్ఫిగరేషన్ 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, ఓకే 3s2, 3p2. సో వాట్ ఇస్ ద ఔటర్ మోస్ట్ షెల్? ఔటర్ మోస్ట్ షెల్ ఇస్ ద థర్డ్ ఇస్ ద ఔటర్ మోస్ట్ షెల్. Outermost shell is third. So therefore it belongs to third period. Actually the third period lo mottam third shell un elements untayi. Next, what is the number of electrons? Outermost shell lo number of electrons in outermost shell. So outermost shell how many electrons are there? So 2 plus 2, therefore total 4 electrons. So 4 electrons kabatti therefore it belong to 14th group. 14th group are simply we can say it is a 48 group. So like this we have to write the group number and period number easily. So for maximum element you can follow this. So in the next session we see the other part of a periodic table. Okay, but you have to remember and practice the all groups which we completed today.